my experience being Japanese and earthquake bird, it was a lot of work.
What is your job?
I'm a translator at Sasaka.
ご家族も一緒に?
私だけです。お父さんのお仕事は? 電気屋さん。
Speaking another language in a film, I've done it a few times. I did a film in Danish, A Royal Affair, which was my first time away from my native language, Swedish. And then, of course, speaking in English was, a big first step as well.
Oh, it's kind of cut that.
To learn somewhere between 7 to 10 scenes, probably where I spoke Japanese, I had to memorize every single word. I had both a language coach, I had an actress, I used my makeup lady every morning who's both fluent in English and Japanese, and I actually started with reading out loud the scene translated in English to get a sense of what it is I wanted to act and what, you know, to come forward. And if you are bilingual, you know that it's such a cultural difference in how you explain yourself with different words and languages. So when I acted it out in English, they actually rewrote the Japanese version because they were like, oh, the way you say that, or maybe you use a bit of sarcasm or the joy that comes through in that sentence, you would probably explain this way in Japanese. So then we went a second round. The difficulty that we were facing was, of course, that I couldn't learn Japanese in 2-3 months, but I wanted to understand as much about the language as possible. And when we did this translation of the second round, when they had heard me act the scene out in English, then it was interesting because then all these discussions about what words actually mean and how they come across in different cultures and how it's actually very different. And, you know, they have a way of addressing people like, you know, like we would say you to somebody. They have, like, I don't know, a lot more options of that. And how you address somebody, of course, you know, immediately changes what the situation looks like. And, I mean, we ended up changing the script and the translation until on the day, which was very difficult sometimes. I went to Japan the first time 4 or 5 years ago, and I think it was the one country since when I was a kid that I really, really wanted to go to, and I had always had this fascination of their culture. And then to get this chance to not only get to go and film in Japan, but also actually get to, you know, have knowledge about the language and work with, I think, 75-80% of our crew were Japanese, which was, you know, an experience for a lifetime. And also doing another language or accent immediately kind of helps you to transform into another character and another person.